My name is Chris Henry. I'm a professor and water management engineer. And I am really excited to be here today to talk to you about what's going on these fields. I've been dreaming about this project for years, 5 years ago, when I was asked to lay out the irrigation at the Northeast Rice Research and Extension Center, now under the leadership of Dr. Tim Burcham and his great crew. We have put in this large experiment to study this pitless tailwater system. So what we've been trying to do for the last decade is improve the furrow-irrigated rice system. You know, it's a real challenge to irrigate furrow-irrigated rice. We pool water at the bottom. We're trying to time irrigation so we don't have too much water. If we put too much water on, we have water leave the field. If we don't irrigate enough, what happens is we kind of burn up in the middle. And it makes it really challenging to irrigate furrow-irrigated rice. So one of our technologies we developed to deal with this situation or improve the furrow-irrigated rice system is our pitless pump, which is behind me. And so we have set up two 50-acre fields, a control field, which is furrow-irrigated rice. We irrigate it with soil moisture sensors on a 3 to 5 day schedule. We put the normal recommended fertilizer on in three or four shots of urea. And we measure how much water goes on that field and how much comes off. Then we do the same thing with our pitless system, which is behind me, only we recirculate that water from the bottom of the field to the top with this very small 3 horsepower pump that continuously recirculates the water from the bottom to the top, allows us to keep the soil moisture in the field much more consistent top to bottom, very low cost, very efficient. So we've set these two up to compare, and on the control field, we're sitting around 15 acre inches of water. We need about another 6 inches of water to finish it, so we'll end up somewhere around the low 20s to finish it. We put 180 pounds of nitrogen on. You'll see often in that row rice field that we see a difference in maturity and height. The bottom tends to mature a little quicker and head out, and the top kind of catches up with it as the year goes on. On the tailwater side, on our pitless irrigation system, we've seen a very uniform head out. We've only put on 75 pounds of nitrogen compared to the 180. We've only put on 9 inches. We expect another 2 inches of water. So we're gonna end up less than 12 inches of water on this field compared to 21. Almost half, we think, of the nitrogen, and about less than half of the fertilizer applied to this field. Instead of trying to split it, we continuously applied water and metered in the fertilizer, kind of right at tillering on for about a 5 or 6 week period. So we had about 6 applications, short applications kind of during the week of urea. This project's been sponsored by Yara. So we use some of their fertilizer product, a 23% UAN solution with calcium in it, in addition to a little bit of 32% UAN versus urea on the control side. So two different forms of fertilizer. It's planted to 75-21. Both fields are planted to 75-21 RiceTech hybrids. They both sponsored this research. Then it's also been supported by the Arkansas Rice Research and Promotion Board to sponsor this research and get it on the ground with the tailwater pump. Then also, who's also supporting this project, because it's we're also looking at the global warming potential of the two fields. So in addition to the water savings and the fertilizer savings, we're looking at how much CO2 and methane and nitrous oxide is coming off the field. So that work is being done by the United States Department of Agriculture, ARS, Ag Research Service, the Delta Water Management Center. Dr. Michelle Reba's team has micromet towers downwind of both fields. So we're able to measure the emissions and what happens to that nitrogen after we apply it. And are we able to make this a more climate smart system? We really believe by managing the soil moisture in the control field, it's been hovering right around, on average, 34% volumetric water content. The field capacity is 35% volumetric water content. So we're hovering right around field capacity, right in this band where we think we don't get any nitrous oxide that comes off these fields. And so compared to the control field, that's been hovering around 20-25% volumetric water content. So the field's stayed wetter and more consistent than our control field. That's one of the things we found in our study. So this technology, again, available to farmers. You can go into your Natural Resource Conservation Service, your local office, and ask for one of these tailwater systems to be installed on your farm. There's cost share available. The cost share will pay for about half of it. The other half of the cost, I think, will be picked up in 22 when we had a really dry year and it was hard to maintain irrigation, especially on furrigated rice fields. We saw a 25 bushel yield advantage in our tailwater system compared to a 3-day irrigation cycle. So a really dry year, just one dry year, will probably make up any cost differences or actually put money back in your pocket with all the other advantages that can happen with furrigated rice, things like planting early, a lot less tillage. These fields can now be no-tilled. We can leave beds intact and not have to till them up. So there's a lot of advantages to row rice. This system, I think, helps us close the gap and bring things to the forefront so we can both be climate smart and improve our profitability of our rice farmers in Arkansas. So thank you all for your support.